Equations, level 2. All right, let's work on the following examples. Solve the equation x plus 5 is equal to 11 if x is an element of 0, 2, 4, and 6. Like in the previous video, let's set up a table as follows. The first column will contain the elements of the domain, in this case 0, 2, 4, and 6. The second column is where we substitute the variable of the equation with its respective element. The third column will contain the simplified equation after substituting the elements into the equation. And lastly, the final column will keep track if the statement obtained is either true or false. So substituting the first element of the domain into the equation and simplifying yields the statement 5 is equal to 11, which is absolutely false. Next, we substitute the second element of the domain, in this case 2, into the equation, which simplifies to the statement 7 is equal to 11, which is false. Moving along, we substitute the third element of the domain, the number 4, into the equation, and simplifying the expression yields the statement 9 is equal to 11, which is also false. Lastly, we substitute the final expression of the domain, in this case, the number 6, into the equation, and then we simplify the expression, which reduces to the statement 11 is equal to 11, which is a true statement. Looking at the results, we see that only one element in the domain yielded a true statement. Therefore, the solution set is 6. Alright, let's try the next example. Solve the equation x times the quantity 3 minus x is equal to 0, if x is an element of 0, 1, 2, and 3. Alright, just like the previous problem, let's set up a table and start systematically substituting the elements of the domain into the equation. The first element is 0, so we substitute that into the equation, which yields the statement 0 is equal to 0, which is a true statement. The second element of the domain is 1, so substituting that into the equation yields the statement 2 is equal to 0, which is false. The third element is 2, so substituting that into the equation yields the statement 2 is equal to 0, which is also false. Lastly, the element 3 is substituted into the equation, which yields the statement 0 is equal to 0, which is true. Looking at the results, we see that two elements of the domain yielded the true statement. Therefore, the solution set is 0 and 3. Notice that in this example, the equation had more than one solution or root that satisfied the equation. In other words, the element led to a true statement. Alright, let's try the next example. Solve the equation z plus 5 is equal to z plus 5 if z is an element of 0, 1, and 2. Once again, we set up a table as follows and systematically go through each element of the domain. So substituting the first element, we have the statement 5 is equal to 5, which is a true statement. The second element is the number 1, and substituting that into the equation yields the statement 6 is equal to 6, which is also a true statement. Lastly, the third element of the domain is the number 2. Substituting it into the equation yields the statement 7 is equal to 7, which is also a true statement. Notice that every single element in the domain yielded a true statement. Therefore, the solution set is 0, 1, and 2. Let's try the next example. Solve the equation 2x equals x plus 7 if x is an element of 0 and 1. Notice that we only have two elements in the domain. Like always, let's create a table and substitute each element of the domain into the equation. Substituting the first element into the equation and simplifying, we have the statement 0 is equal to 7, which is false. The last element in the domain is 1, and after substituting it into the equation, we have the statement 2 is equal to 8, which is also false. Looking at the results, we see that there isn't a single element in a domain that yielded a true statement. This means that the equation has no solution over the given domain. In this example, there wasn't an element in the given domain that yielded a true statement, meaning there wasn't a solution or root that satisfied the equation. Recall that the solution set is dependent on the domain given. For example, if we work with the same equation but with a completely different domain, say the domain that contains the elements 6 and 7, we would obtain a completely different answer. So let's try it out. Substituting the first element into the equation yields the statement 12 is equal to 13, which is a false statement. The last element yields the statement 14 is equal to 14, which is a true statement. Looking at the results, we see that only one element yielded a true statement. Therefore, the solution set is equal to 7. Notice that the solution to the equation is dependent on the domain for which we are solving the equation. This is an important concept that many students from higher level mathematics, such as calculus and differential equations, tend to forget. Alright, in our next video, we will learn how to translate written words into numerical and variable expressions.